decide on a holiday party.
The discussion was going to eject the pop cars.
Yes. We just didn't talk about date, they were on, I believe.
No, date was not.
Did y'all not call and get a reservation?
I don't know location, but not a date, and we're.
And Molly, are you gonna work out with the county manager to pick up the tab?
There's a precedent now, Molly.
Well, the precedent was that the chairman challenged the.
Oh.
The front people. Oh, the challenge.
Hey, I was sitting up here right now.
And the city.
He did, Molly, you're right.
My understanding is what was gonna happen again.
Okay, well, I will extend that text tomorrow morning to the mayor and also the chair of Lowndes County and see if we can't get some funds put together, see if they will at least contribute what they did last year to the planning commission holiday party. And so, do we don't have a date?
We do not.
I have a couple of suggestions for dates. Sticking with, I think, what we did last year is during the course of the week and not the weekend. The 11th or the 13th, a Tuesday.
Monday night or Tuesday?
I wanna say it was a Tuesday night, but I could be mistaken.
The 11th is the county commission meeting.
Okay, and what does the 13th look like? Nothing?
It's Thursday, the 13th. No conflict that I'm aware of.
Anybody have a conflict with Thursday, the 13th?
What day?
Thursday, the 13th.
What time?
Where's it gonna be?
At Jack's Chalk House.
Where is that?
That's the old.
You're for the legs of that living?
Charlie Trippers.
Yeah.
Green House, right.
North Front House.
What do they have there?
State.
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 When you run off.
And a few other things too.
My barbecue?
No, it's state.
It's state.
Yeah.
I'll be coming in from out of town, that's mine.
Will you be here in time?
Maybe.
If you can't either, can we go and get your $20?
Yeah, sure.
Are you out of town about that whole week?
No.
Okay.
I'll be flying in, so I'll be coming on at 4:30 flight.
Okay.
Okay, so who's gonna make the call? Ms. Carmella, Ms. Molly?
Lieutenant.
So, can we give an alternate date in case we've already got somebody for the 13th?
Why don't we just kick it back to the 10th, that Monday?
I'm good with that, I'm open for that too.
Are they open on Mondays?
10th or the 13th?
I think they are, yeah.
Yeah.
So, ask, check those 2 days. The 10th, Lou.
That's correct.
The Monday?
Monday, the 10th.
Yeah.
Okay. Also.
He can do either.
Yes.
13th is the preference.
Preference, 13th, 7 o'clock?
That's fine. That's fine. Alright, so we'll look at that, Molly, so just send email out and I will, I'll send a text to those two gentlemen tomorrow, see if we can count on their contribution again this year for all the hard work all these commissioners do for the last 11 months. So, we'll see if they do. With all that being said, at this time, I'll take a motion for adjournment.
One thing, Mr. Chairman.
Wait, I'm sorry.
It's not on the agenda too. One of our commission members who's not here this evening has been elected to public office as a mayor.
Really?
And that's sort of unusual to have that kind of overlap. And I don't know if we wanna have some informal discussion about that now or wait till the January work session. But I don't know, there's nothing that prohibits it here. I don't know about that local government ordinance, but we can look and see. But we don't know if that member is going to resign or not.
That's a conflict.
I would like to, just speak to that because this is gonna come up again. In about 3 years, this is probably gonna come up again. So, Franklin had mentioned a conflict of interest. And that was my question because as a mayor, you're looking out for the betterment of the city, but that's actually what we're doing here as well. So I don't see it as a conflict of interest, I'm wondering what the perception would look like to the community.
Exactly. And going back many years ago, about 20, almost 25 years ago, one of Valdosta's appointees was a city council member, sort of as a part of a rotating tradition. And during the late 90s, the council member that since then, I'm not aware of any time where we've had that. I know we've had members of the planning commission who have been elected, and they have then resigned after the election.
See, there's a difference though between a council member and a mayor, because a mayor is basically in the position like Franklin is in, you know, as far as breaking a tie with council. So I kind of see it as a difference there, but I do think we need to probably resolve it, because I know it's going to come up again.
At this point, I would, if we want to take action, I would do it as a form of a recommendation to that member government. I still think that member government has the ability to choose whoever they want to choose to represent them on the planning commission, but maybe as a recommendation or even a question posed from our chairman to that member government.
I think we need to recommend them to, and if they want to keep the mayor, fine. If they don't, then we'll want somebody else. The ball is in their court.
Yeah, has he said whether or not he intends to continue to not serve what you've been doing?
I have not spoken with him. What we could do, maybe I could ghostwrite a letter from the chairman to the current mayor of that government posing the question. Because I venture to guess into something they have not yet called out.
The perception of not being good.
And then, Matt, you guys are still working on the adding Ringerton, right?
Correct.
Are we making any headway there?
We are trying to whittle away the cooks in the kitchen.
Okay.
To get it more focused. But expect to have that on your work session agenda, Jay.
Oh, awesome.
We have not only planning staff, but we have legal staff in the picture now.
Matt, this is one thing on our current planning commission members, on Commissioner Wiles, his expiration.
Expiration?
He started in 2000. When starting date was 2000, like 2010, you need to make a note of that.
It started 2000 instead of 2010?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
When Betty Bechtel ended her.
Okay.
I think Betty Bechtel.
Okay.
How do we know when the expiration of their memo?
It's all the stuff we got back.
Open eyes.
Okay, so Matt, any more unfinished business that you didn't report or that we need to talk about this morning? That being said, we had an earlier motion to adjourn. And I would say, y'all have a great evening. Thanks so much for letting me serve in this chair.